There you see our officials. That's Danica Mosher set to throw it up in the middle along with Tony Petillo and Roy Soban. Turner has the loose ball. Here's a three from Nurse. It's no good and still fought for. Mercury get another chance. Griner down low. Turner lays it up.
Great opportunities for the Mercury with those second and third opportunities.
And Breezy have been doing a lot of damage this week. Inside. They'll try to do it again tonight. Here's Tina Charles. She's used to doing damage, and there's her turnaround jumper connecting on the baseline.
On the defensive end for the Mystics, they've done a good job as far as pushing the offense out on the Mercury.
Natasha Cloud able to knock it down from deep. Mercury still unable to find the range. That's now 0 for 4 from beyond the arc to get this game started. Now Hines Allen, a nice move in the lane to get the left-hander to go off the window. Phoenix dominating that one, winning by 21, 91-70 back on May 18th. Taurasi almost had it stolen away, but ripped it out of the hands of Cloud. Now it's Griner doing what she does in the paint and working over Tina Charles that time. But she's shooting nearly 40% from deep this season. Here's Diggins Smith, thought about the three, instead penetrating. Down low, Turner another. Nice layup off a beautiful feet.
Her coaches and her teammates have encouraged her to take more shots, and she's so unselfish, but she can score a lot of baskets, and it's only going to help the Mercury.
Nice hesitation drive there by Ariel Atkins.
Kind of helping everybody with the defensive schemes.
Griner had a nice move, got her own miss, put it up and in. Brittany Griner just using those post moves on Tina Charles down low. Now Shatori Walker-Kimbrough blowing by her defender and getting right to the basket after those three free throws. Now 1 for 6 for Washington. Diggins Smith around a Griner screen, open from 16. That's Cat.
She did such a nice job keeping her dribble alive and using the screen.
On the penetration off the switch, Turner guarding her. Now Charles has a mismatch against Diggins Smith. Tried to use it and did. She got the roll on the turn and gun.
She does such a nice job getting deep in the lane.
Now she's got 6 points to lead the Mystics. Back ahead by 4. We get a steal, and it'll be an easy coast-to-coast layup for Ariel Atkins. Left is Griner quickly the other way. She'll get it done inside the paint, and Brittany Griner now with 8 points. At Pinnacle High School, North Phoenix. Natasha Cloud all alone, and she drills it again. That's a long two, though. Her foot was on the line. 26 seconds to go in the first, and the Mercury trail by 6.
Well, things would really open up for the Mercury and Brittany Griner if the outside players would start hitting some shots.
The 5 on the floor for Mike Kimbrough. Here's Taurasi handling for Phoenix. Into the corner, Smith finds Cunningham open, and she cans the 3 straight away.
The Energizer Bunny.
That has continued to rise since the Olympic break as she has had excellent shooting performances in each of the first two games and now knocks down her 3, and Leilani Mitchell answers on the other end.
And she's back in Phoenix.
Here's Taurasi fading and hitting off the left block. Coming off another solid performance, 22 on Tuesday night with 7 assists. She's driving the lane and Weiss able to hit.
Yeah, tough shot. That was right-handed. She's a left-handed player.
Alana Smith and Leilani Mitchell both collecting themselves in the backcourt still.
Yeah, Smith never really had the angle to get that shot to go down and just collided with the defense. And then Weiss comes back and knocks down.
And the Mercury need to get some stops as Washington starts to get a little bit of space. Leilani Mitchell drives against Petty, puts up the shot and hits as she hits the deck, fading away. As you mentioned, usually dangerous from deep, but that time penetrating as well. As the Mercury get it started out of the timeout right with a jumper from Kia Vaughn.
Getting points and getting open for shots.
Mitchell finds Weiss in the corner. Can't hit the 3 that time, but an offensive rebound. The putback goes for Tina Charles. Count it, and she'll have a chance at a 3-point play. Megan Smith drew the foul, and now here's a steal by Hines Allen. She's going to go one-on-one with Turner. Left-hand shot up and in. How about that? She made the defensive play, then took it coast-to-coast.
Not pushing the ball whatsoever. They have 0 fast break points.
This has been the majority of their offense. Brittany Griner taking it deep, and she's able to hit again. 11-point lead for Washington. Griner back into the lane, spinning into double-team coverage. Got the basket and the foul. Brittany Griner to the line with a deuce. Here they come, trying to cut into this 8-point lead. It's been as big as 12 in these last couple minutes. Diggins Smith, again, finding Griner, putting it up and in off the window, and Brittany Griner has it cooking here tonight in Phoenix. He forced Cloud into a tough shot, though, and Griner got the loose ball. Here comes Taurasi. penetrating, hanging, and hitting the fadeaway.
What a soft reach on that.
We wish you well if you are a member of that crowd out there, as we know. So many are. Tina Charles driving into the lane right on Brittany Griner, gets it started out. Now they get a third chance on this possession. Tina Charles jacking up another three, and that one's nothing but net. Diggin Smith posting up Brittany Griner, spins on McCall into the lane, reverse layup up and in.
And this is a Washington team that is being outshot.
Here comes the Mercury into the forecourt. Diggin Smith finds Griner down to 3 seconds. She's double teamed. Open, it's Cunningham at the buzzer. She knocked it down. Sophie Cunningham makes it a 5-point lead for Washington at the half. Here's Kia Nurse. She just picked up her third personal foul there. Mercury down 6. Brittany Griner going to work again in the post, and she has her way against Tina Charles. 4-point lead for Washington. Here's Hines Allen. Little step back pump fake. Can't get it, but got her own miss. Takes it up strong on Turner and finishes. You mentioned her strength, and she put it on display right there. 6 points for Hines Allen and a 6-point lead for the Mystics. Almost another steal by Shatori Walker-Kimbrough. Now here's Skylar Diggins-Smith for 3. And the high arcer gets nothing but the bottom of the net.
It was a key play.
Charles double team, bounce pass knocked away. Turner got it. Now she's going to be loose in the forecourt, and she'll lay it off the window and in.
Now Turner's one of those players you just never really notice what she does out there.
Finds Diggins-Smith on the move. She gives it back to BG. The up fake, the drive. On the run, lost it, got it back, and finished.
Well, that might have been a blocked shot, but it went back to Brittany Griner.
Tina Charles now with 16 after knocking down those free throws to put the Mystics back up a point. Griner going to work again in the lane. The fade rolls in, and she's got 26. She's made her last 3 shots.
Hold everybody else.
How about Griner finding Sophie Cunningham open in the corner? She can't hit that time. But an offensive board by Turner, and now Diggin Smith to the basket. And she lays it in. There's Griner. Spinning away from the basket with Charles defending. Two-man game with Diggin Smith. She's going to try her luck. The 3 on the way. She can, another one.
Oh,
Skylar Diggin Smith, 2 for 2. Leading by 6, biggest edge of the game for the Mercury. Petty finds Cunningham all alone for 3. She got another one. 3-time WNBA Coach of the Year, Mike Tebow over
there. The winningest coach in the WNBA.
And now Brittany Griner has an open shot on the baseline, and she knocked it down. Cloud, a wraparound pass to Charles, hook shot no good. Hines Allen the offensive board, and she got another putback. She's their only player in double figures. There's Sydney Weiss, a long 3 is up and in. And that is her 2nd trifecta of the night. And Diana Taurasi finds Kia Vaughn. They'll leave her all alone, and she'll make them pay.
Now, Kia Vaughn's capable of making the outside shot.
How about Kia Vaughn? Left open, doesn't shoot it this time. Instead, feeds Griner, and she will feed the hoop.
Griner, 30 points.
Gets out of the double team. Here comes Diggin Smith into the forecourt. She has an opening and uses it. She beats Tina Charles to the rim. Brittany Griner, by the way, 30 points, leading all scores. It's her 3rd 30-point game of the season. Now she has her hands on it again. To a cutting Kia Vaughn, who lays it up and in. That was pretty. Skylar on the right-hand dribble, hesitates. Baseline, nice move, off the glass, count that baby, and the foul. And it helps when you've got a player like this, Brittany Griner, doing her thing.
Oh, nice pass.
Smith, wide open, Kia Vaughn to lay it in.
19 assists. It was a slow start for her, but she came on.
Leilani Mitchell canning the 3. As we talked about, she likes to shoot here in Phoenix.
You know, she's so much fun to watch and such a true leader.
Don't see players win that award twice very often. And she did. She won it in 2010. Again, a lot of misses by Washington has helped that rebound total.
And they kept Washington off the glass.
That's right. Although not on this possession, Erica McCall able to get the follow down to the last 4 seconds. And that will do it. The Mercury win it. Final score, 77-60.